வணக்கம், மை ஹைதர் அலி சையத் ஆசிர்வாதம் சே யுனைடெட் அண்டர் தமிழ் சேவா.
Hi, this is Venkat Raghavan from Nanganallur. After creating Earth and other beings and Adam and his family, did Almighty God have any interference with Earth as well as humanity?
God knows the future of everything. He does not interfere with anyone's day-to-day life. Whatever they have are facing is because of their karma and karma of their ancestors. Karma is nothing but doing good or bad deeds against the God's balancing system. Since God is merciful, so He rectifies the straight people by sending many prophets to the world time to time. Other than that, He does not interfere with human life.
When God has nothing to do with human life, then what is the use of worshipping Him?
God does not need any ritual, worship or prayer. Ritual, worship and priestly cult will not help in connecting with God. It will help only Varnadharam. Every human having God's particle which can connect with God directly without any intermediator. To connect soul with God, one must do yoga, meditation and activate Kundalini chakra as taught by Almighty to first Siddhar Tamil Shiva Alai Sait.
According to our tradition, Lord Murugan being immortal, Nova is no more now. So how can you tell Murugan and Nova is the same person? So very complicated question, right? How are you going to answer?
As per tradition, there are three things immortal. One is Pati, which referring to God. Second is Pasu, which referring to soul. Soul is God's particle, so it's immortal. Soul and God is one. And the third is Pasam, referring to bondage or dark lord. Every human is a living God, as they have God's particle, which calling as soul or Atma. In that case, including Murugan, all humans are living God. Quran chapter 2 verse 154 says, "And call not those who are slain in the way of Allah dead, nay, they are living, only you perceive not." Tamil tradition says, Tamil Shiva is the first Siddha and Murugan also a Siddha. All Siddhas activated Kundalini chakras, they destroyed bondage with real material world, in other words, Dark Lord. So we cannot consider them to be dead or alive. We cannot perceive about them too.
You said the great flood is only to Seth and his family. Why God made a great deluge?
Scientific community of Tamil nation indulge in experiment on genetic engineering, climate control and on advanced experiments in a destructive manner. Because of that only, glacier melt, Noah flood took place. God did not interfere with Noah flood. It's a man-made destruction. Karma or action of individual and collectively decides the future action on earth. God does not interfere. Still, God is merciful, so He sent His prophet to protect the life on earth and set balance.
Then how come children of Cain were not affected by this great flood?
Cain committed the first murder. Cain was cursed and banished from cradle of civilization, Sri Lanka, Tamil Nadu, Kumarikandam. Cain, a fugitive on earth with a sign. Because of Cain's karma or action, his coming generation were barbaric race. They were hunter-gatherer, uncivilized society. Until recent age, they did not civilize. Scientific community of ancient Tamil indulged in genetic engineering and climate control and other advanced research and experiments that caused disbalance, which brought disasters among Tamil colonies spread across globe. As children of Cain was banished and from civilized Tamil colony, generation of Cain were not involved in advanced destructive researches at that time. So Noah flood did not affect the children of Cain and their land as they were far away from epicenter.
Now what is the proof you are having that Shiva is not a uncivilized person? I also just required a solid answer for this.
Vanakkam, thank you.